I've always believed that traveling is good for the soul, and I absolutely miss everything about it. Now that domestic travel is allowed with safety protocols in place, I decided to visit some of my closest friends who have the luxury of transforming their vacation homes into their primary place of dwelling. This year, our lives have drastically changed, but the quest to bring you the stories on people, places, and meaningful experiences continues. This is Raul Manzano, EIC On The Move. They say the home is our sanctuary, but now, working from home has forced us to mix business and pleasure in our personal spaces. Now, more than ever, surrounding ourselves in peaceful ambiance is essential for productivity. This is when having a rest home comes in handy. Today, in the first episode of this two-part series, I visit Toni Leviste in her beautiful home in Lipa, Batangas. Toni, in case you didn't know, is a Filipina equestrian who has represented the Philippines in the international competitions from 2000 and 2008 Summer Olympics to the 2002 and 2010 Asian Games. I've known Toni since her teenage years. She's also a good friend of my niece, Mikey Kowanko Jaworski, who is an award-winning equestrian herself. Hi, Toni.
Hi, Tito Raul.
Thank you so much for having me here.
I'm so happy you're here. You look so fit and as handsome as ever.
You look just as good as when I first met you when you were, how old?
10?
10.
Yeah, wow. No.
Still look the same, still looking good.
Thank you.
Last time I was here, we did some shoots for Metro Society. Some things have changed, right?
Yes.
You've built new structures around the farm. What did you do?
So, a lot, actually. Because you don't visit me enough.
Yeah, I will visit you now more often.
So, I built a covered arena so that when it rains, which we have a lot of, especially here in Lipa, the riders, including myself and my clients and the students, can continue on riding under the roof. And it's made with high quality, world class footing so that it's less injury for the horses. And we also built a new stable, so it's the annex barn. Actually, two new stables. We have the annex barn, which is behind the main barn, and also a quarantine stable. So the quarantine stables are for horses that just arrived from Europe.
How long do they have to be in quarantine?
Normally 30 days.
30 days.
Yeah, 30 days in quarantine. Yeah. And it's a little bit further in the back of the farm. And also beside the moss bell. And the moss bell is a very special place, Tito. I'm going to take you there later. But it's called the moss bell because it's a mosque and a chapel.
So it's both for Catholics and for Muslims.
Yes, well, I am Muslim. The rest of my family is Catholic. But it's really a meditation and prayer room. So it's for everybody to want to stay quiet and connect to the higher spirit.
And the drive down from the entrance is quite impressive with all the trees lining the...
You like it? So we planted those trees when they were 2 feet tall. So almost just like seedlings. And they are currently like 15 to 16 years old. And they're already like giants.
It's like you're driving down the European farm. You know, with all the trees lining the path.
I would always say that that is my best view when I look down the Acacia Lane, is what we call it.
You've remodeled your house, right?
Yes, I have.
So I'm dying to see it.
Anton Barreto was the one who designed it. So he's dying to show you as his masterpiece. And I will show you around later, Tito. So we'll go into my house and show you the new barns as well, the covered arena where I'm going to give you a lesson.
Okay, no jumping.
Why not? I want to see you jumping.
Okay, we'll try one out. I brought my boots.
You did? Okay, very good. And helmet also?
No.
That's really important.
I'll just borrow one.
Yeah, we'll lend you one. Exactly. Also, Tito, I wanted to let you know that since I met you when I was 10, I already had this dream of the farm in my mind. But it took 30 more years before it actually materialized. It took 3 years to build, but 30 years in a dream. And now it has come to a reality. So I envisioned a farm where it would be a home for the horses that I love. And it would be a sanctuary where horses can be loved and cared for.
Yeah.
And it's more a home for horses and the humans are just guests.
That's a beautiful thing to say. Now, since the pandemic, okay, what has changed? What has become more meaningful to you?
Well, I think for a lot of people, it makes them, well, no choice. You have to be quiet and still.
Yes.
Although doing nothing is different from being still, right? And I found a lot of, discovered a lot of realizations about my life and what's important to me.
Yeah.
And I think a lot of people have come to the same realization that family above all is important. And normally I travel a lot for competitions representing the country abroad. And I've come home to be with my parents who are of course getting older. And because we don't have a major championship at this moment and it's still not sure about next year depending if the vaccine is gonna come out and how things will be travel wise. But I've realized that it's more important to stay close to your family at this moment. It's a crisis, even if it's a world crisis, it's more really an interpersonal realization of how important your loved ones are to you. And no matter where in the world I am, my heart stays here.
It stays here.
Yeah, with the people that live here, the staff, who are like family to me. They've been with me for with us in our family for over 30 years and the horses that live here.
So during the pandemic, this home has become even more meaningful to you.
Yes, exactly. Because we take care of each other, right?
Yes,
so
right.
We have our own bayanihan within the farm.
Okay, that's
helping the families of the staff and the staff being even more masigasig to do their best for the clients that come. For them, it's more important.
Yes.
So I can see the change there, that it's more important for the riders and the horse owners to come regularly.
Yeah.
I guess they feel that it's an escape and it's a fresh, it's fresh air.
Yeah, it's a fresh getaway from Manila.
Exactly.
Yeah. And the weather when we got here this morning, wow. I forgot. I should have brought the jacket. And it's really cold. It was cold. Huh?
Oh, because Tito, Lipa is actually the highest point of Batangas.
Okay, I didn't
you
know
don't
that.
Feel it
yeah.
because it's a gradual incline.
Okay.
But it's a few thousand meters above sea level.
That's why look at the wind.
Yeah, exactly. My hat is being blown off.
So let's look at now what you've done inside the house.
Yeah, okay, good. I'm excited.
Me too.
Welcome to my home.
Yes.
This was masterfully done, especially for me, by Anton Barreto.
Oh, our good friend.
Our good friend.
Yes, right. And did you like the colors bright? Because it's a nice bright room. Huh?
Right. Yes. So I wanted it to feel sunny.
Yes.
Like I wanted to depict the outside, inside.
Mm-hmm.
Although I did let Anton know that I wanted neutral furniture. And he agreed with me because we had a lot of pieces from my travels abroad that were very bright in fabric.
Yes.
So he said that that would be perfect to add an accent and to let those colors pop out.
Let's go look into what you have in your living room.
So I wanted to start with these throw pillows, actually, because they came from Syria, from the famous market in Aleppo.
Aleppo, yes.
Yes, so I love them because it brings so much fond memories.
Yeah, and also color into the room.
Exactly.
Like, this is like your accent piece for the very neutral polish you have here, no?
And then, as you see, we have the Quran.
The Quran, yeah.
I am Muslim.
Muslim, yeah.
When I see it on the table, it reminds me to pray.
Yes.
We have to pray five times a day, as you know.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then all the little pieces here all came from somewhere special to me.
Yeah.
Like this teapot came from Morocco.
Morocco.
And some of them are gifts to me. Mm-hmm. All the books also were gifts or mean something that we were, Anton and I would look through while we were deciding how to finish up the house. Some of the other items that you see here were from Africa or from Spain.
Yes.
I still remember, like, Anton is like, how come you haven't lit my candle? That was a gift from him, from Chereo, his candle place. So, like I said, everything that you see, every single piece that's here has a special meaning to me.
Yeah.
And everything, most of it came from special people as presents or gifts and from traveling
and what
abroad.
I like about the house, it's surrounded by greenery. I mean, you know, you look out the window, there are plants. You look out your front, you have that whole garden and that whole pathway coming in the acacia lane.
Right.
I mean, it's just very, feels like home.
It is, it does.
Yeah.
And Tito, as you see, there's also very high ceilings.
Ceilings,
like, it's like cathedral ceilings.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because I wanted it to feel very airy.
Yeah.
Already as you were coming in, you could feel the breeze,
and
right?
And crosswind.
Exactly, cross ventilation, that was very important as well. And I wanted to be able to sit here on the couch, look outside, and not need a TV.
Yes. Right.
Because what's more beautiful than nature?
Yeah, you don't have a TV here, right?
Yeah, exactly.
A lot of people have TVs in their living room, right?
Anton was the one who convinced me, actually. Yeah. You must not put a TV here. My God.
You know, Anton doesn't like TVs.
Yeah, exactly. So I am a TV buff, in fact.
Mm-hmm.
But when I'm here, I don't feel the need
for
to turn it on.
But you have those beautiful gardens around you.
Right. So in front is the acacia lane. When I'm sitting here, I see that. And
you can also
to my
see
side,
your
it's the stables.
Coming in, right?
Yeah, exactly.
And you can see your horses there.
Exactly.
And your friends and your other friends.
Right. All my friends. Tito, let's go to the dining room.
Okay.
There's still a lot for
I
me to show
imagine,
you there.
Okay, if there's already this much, I can imagine what's there.
Right.
What a nice dining room, huh?
Thank you, Tito.
But before we get to the details, so how has the pandemic affected your personal life and the life in the farm?
I've lived a socially distanced life all my life.
Yes, true. Yeah.
Life was only about horses and competing abroad. And when I travel abroad, I feel like a gypsy, actually.
Yeah.
A modern-day gypsy, because I go from one country to the other and one city to the next by myself with my horse caretaker, my groom, and with my coach.
Yeah.
We travel all around and I basically live alone and concentrating on the competition.
Yeah.
So when the pandemic happened, I still am doing the same thing that I'm doing.
Yeah.
And of course, it's quite sad that you don't get to see your friends often.
Mm-hmm.
But because I'm not home in the Philippines a lot, I don't really get
you
to see them a lot. Yes. So to begin with, these leather lamps that you see hanging here, I bought in Morocco.
Yeah.
Like 20 years ago, in one of my trips there. And
it's made out of leather.
Yes, it's made out of leather and some Moroccan glass.
Yes.
That's why it's you see the bits of color around it. And when I saw it in the market, in one of those souks in Morocco, I thought, oh, this would be perfect for my house in Lipa. But I didn't have a house yet.
So you're already thinking that far.
Yes, exactly. So. In fact, the whole concept of the house came from these lamps that I saw in the market.
So you built the house around the lamps.
Exactly, right?
Perfect.
So, and then I was thinking, okay, they can't just hang on the wall because they're too special to hang on the wall just like that. So I have a friend who is also a writer, Tata Montilla, and he does hand painting.
Yes, I know.
On the walls,
he
he did it.
It looks like wallpaper.
That, right.
That's all by hand.
Yes, and he was upside down.
Yeah.
For a few weeks doing that.
Okay.
So I like to make them suffer too. To make it beautiful.
And then this I'm so in love with.
Right.
This is a beautiful piece of wood, right?
Yes. So it's, Anton Barreto says, it's like almost 100 years old.
It looks
I'm
it,
not
okay?
sure if I should believe him, but why shouldn't we, right? He's our friend.
Yeah.
And he thought it would be perfect on the table because of all the trees around here and it matches everything that you see on the ceiling and he thought it would be really special to put there because when we have guests he could decorate it with flowers, flowers that we see outside fresh in the garden, or with other stuff
that are fruits.
Exactly.
Yeah,
yeah. So, like I said earlier, when we would have our foreign equine professionals come in,
you would entertain them.
Yes. Well, they would live here for the time that they are treating the horses or teaching the students. And they would have their breakfast here, they would have dinners here, and whoever is coming to see their horses being treated or if they have a lesson, they will come to entertain them. We are of course known for our Filipino hospitality. And they all of them say, above all, what is most beautiful about coming to the Philippines are the people.
Yeah.
And I'm so proud when they say that.
All right. Garden, outside, comes into the house.
Exactly. So that's what I was had envisioned when I wanted to build the house finally. That I wanted the outdoors to be also indoors. That's why the colors depict nature.
Yeah.
And when I look out just the window, the garden is directly there.
Yeah.
In fact, what you see out there is the courtyard. So it's between the library, where we have all our paraphernalia and all the history books, of the family and all the books and everything. And we have a little well.
Yes.
So it's like a wishing well. And
remind me to drop a coin and make a wish, okay?
Be careful, it might come true.
Okay, I don't mind.
Sometimes it's nice also to have a coffee, sit outside in the courtyard, which we will do later.
Yeah. But I like the way the garden just comes into the house. And you don't even need any air conditioning. I mean, cross ventilation.
Exactly.
Right?
So we hardly use air conditioning. So I would like it also to be an organic environmental farm.
Yeah.
Where smoking is not allowed.
Okay.
So we teach that to everyone in the staff.
Yeah.
And as much as possible, we plant our own herbs.
Yeah.
And like you see all the plants that we have around, they were beautiful accidents that the gardener, Henry, who's been working here for the last 20 years, just decides to, let's say, plant a wild plant or birds of paradise, for example. And it became the backdrop for the entrance, for example. Or those plants that you like.
Yeah, the big leaf.
Leafy plants.
Which I want to bring some.
Of course, you can take as much as you want. It's my favorite plant, actually, and I keep forgetting what it's called. But he plants a little bit of it, and I tell him, I love that, and he plants the whole place.
Okay, so I see the stables out there. Let's go there now. I'm excited to see the horses.
I'm excited to show you.
Okay, let's go.
The best place of the farm. This is Duchi.
Hi, Duchi.
That's Carissa's horse.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
So horses sense fear, Tito. So every time you come near them, as you know, you have to be very neutral inside, staying calm, so that they don't worry. There, Amber.
There you are.
Good. Hi, Ara. Hi. She's from Sweden.
Wow.
Yeah.
I love her color.
Yeah, so we have a lot of gray horses. So that's Ara, and this is Lulu, who is also gray. Lulu is already 19 years old, turning 20, but she's very, very fit. So as you see, Tito, they're already saddled, ready for you to be ridden. Okay. Are you
ready?
Gung-ho?
Yep, I am.
And just to show you also, this is Toto. Hi, Toto boy. Yeah, hi, Toto.
Hello.
Stirrup.
Okay.
One.
Oops.
Two. Three. Okay. So, Tito, when was the last time you rode?
Wow. 10 years ago.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's like riding a bicycle. You'll never forget it.
Yeah.
Just stay calm inside. Yeah. Like I said, stay neutral.
The horse knows.
Tito Raul, this is the special place I told you about. It's called the Mosfell. And the floor is hand-painted, which Anton Barreto specifically found an artwork.
Okay.
Actually, it was a carpet. And it's called the Tree of Life, which is so fitting for the whole place. And he had it commissioned to paint it by hand. And it took months to finish it.
Can you imagine? Look, it's very intricate.
Yes, exactly. So from afar, actually, you would think it was a carpet.
Yeah, but when you, it's actually, wow.
Right.
Incredible.
And then he also designed the chandeliers, like you would see in a chapel or in a church.
And then, I love the pews.
Yes, so exactly. Anton designed the pews as well. So he wanted to mix metal with our. This is also coming from our own tree.
Okay.
This acacia seats. It's solid, and because it was one big block on its own, and it was all different shapes, and he thought it better to make it look natural, and so he didn't want to slice it to be symmetrical. Everything, everything was like a different size.
Shape, right?
Exactly. Yeah. So that's one beauty of it as well. And as you see, there is
the
a cross which is made of very, very old wood, traviesa, as we call it.
Yeah, traviesa.
Yeah, from the railroad tracks.
Yeah, from the railroad tracks. Right.
So we illuminated the background
the back,
of the of the cross, and we just wanted a very simple background, not very intricate. So it's just plain gray background with the illumination from behind, so that you, when you're here, you will feel very solemn, very calm, and no matter what religion, doesn't matter which religion you you believe in,
so
what's
like
important.
The name Mosfell.
Yes, exactly. So it's unique in the world. It's the only one.
Yes. I've never heard of a Mosfell.
Right. So it only finished last year, but it started in 2016.
Anton designed the floor.
Anton designed everything. Actually, so my dad built it without any architect or engineering. And everything is like, all the windows are not really symmetrical. And then when Anton saw it, he fixed it to make it as symmetrical as possible. But I think the masterpiece of it would be the hand-painted
the floor. I really love the floor.
Right.
And that cross is really...
And the cross. So the cross was my dad's idea, that he, because he has like a lot of old stuff. So he found this old traviesa, and he wanted it to be solemn as well. And that's why we lit up the background, and where the cross is hanging is very simple. It's just a great background, and I love it with the lights on, the chandeliers illuminating.
It's a simple structure, but it has a lot of meaning.
Yes.
Yes. Right?
Right.
You know, it's just like, you know, just a very simple,
right,
but plenty of meaning.
Exactly.
For any religion.
Exactly. One doesn't even have to have an actual religion. You just have to have faith.
Yeah. And you just sit here and everything just sort of flows in.
And like you said earlier, Tito, when you were at the house, you thought that it the outside was coming in. It's the same here.
Yeah,
we have a lot of windows. So
it's all green. Again.
Exactly. So even if you're in an enclosed area and closed space, you just look out and you feel like you're outdoors.
Outdoors, and like you're having mass outside. Right.
Right.
If you are inspired by the design of these areas from Tony's home as much as I was, you can head over to Wilcon, where you can get the right material to recreate your desired space. Wilcon is widely known as the one-stop shop home store, providing all-around home building and improvement needs. Let me show you the many options you can choose from at Wilcon. Thank you. I came in early so I was able to remove my mask, but I'm keeping my face shield on. Hey, Jamie, how are you?
I'm good, Raul. What brings you here?
Okay, last weekend, I was at the home of Toni Leviste in Lipa, Batangas, and I fell in love with her living room. It's a very contemporary Filipiniana look. So I decided, why not do it here at Wilcon? I'll pick up all the pieces from here, right? Because you have everything. How many floors is this building?
This building has 5 floors where you can find any products you will need.
Okay, so I can go crazy here.
Yes, of course. Okay.
So let's go to the furniture area. I have to pick some pieces and some accessories. Okay?
Sure, let me show you around.
Okay, let's go. So, Jamie, we are now here at the furniture area of Wilcon. You have a lot of different brands, no?
Yes, of course. Here at Wilcon, you can find a lot of furniture, regardless if you want it to be contemporary, traditional, modern, anything, you can find it all here.
Now, these two pieces I like for to recreate Tony's house, no? This is a Natuzzi brand. I love the leather, and it's quite comfortable.
Yes, because Natuzzi is also one of our premium brands here at Wilcon. So it's, you can really expect a high quality of this brand.
Yeah, because the leather is really very nice. Huh?
Yes, I know.
And this is very high end, no?
Of course.
Okay, so let's go look for more pieces for the house. See, look, you have a wide array of sofas, cabinets. You actually don't have to leave the place, no?
You don't, because Wilcon provides a wide array of products from plumbing, tiles, sanitary wares, and building, any building materials.
So you can build your kitchen and your bathrooms here, right?
You can find everything here at Wilcon.
Okay, so as I can see the furniture, you also have now dining sets, right?
Yes,
chairs and everything. In fact, these two chairs I like for the living room. Look at this. The material is good. It's comfortable.
Yes.
And the gray goes very well with that brown.
Yes, that's true.
Yeah. So this is perfect. So I need two of these.
Okay. Let's get this.
Okay. Now, let's go to, you have a whole floor also devoted to accessories for the home.
Yes, we do.
So let's go to the accessory room. I'll start picking accessories to elevate the living room. Jamie, let's put the finishing touches on Tony's recreated space.
Yes, let's do it.
And usually we have to have a horse.
Oh, yes, that's true.
Perfect. Okay. So happy that you had horses here.
Okay.
Now, how does that look?
Yeah,
looks good, no? Perfect. So, Jamie, I think we've captured the essence of the living room of Tony
in
Lipa, okay? We've got beautiful leather seats from Natuzzi.
Yes.
Okay, perfect. Nice couches there. Footstools, actually, and two single chairs, okay? We've got, of course, her
horses.
Okay, she rides horses, and it's a horse farm. Her candles, books, lanterns, and vases. So, this is pretty much.
Yes, that's true.
I think upgraded it a bit.
Yes.
Using Wilcon furniture and accessories.
Yes.
I didn't have to leave the building. Okay. So went from floor to floor looking for accessories. So everything's done. So thank you again.
You're welcome. Anytime.
Okay. Yeah. I'm going to be back soon. Okay.
You sure?
Yeah. Thank you, Tony, for having me over the weekend in your beautiful home.
I'm telling you, I had so much fun.
I had so much fun too, Tigger Raul. Yeah. And you have to promise me something. Uh-huh. You have to come back more often.
Remember, as we were walking through the stables, I said, I think I'm going to take dressage again, but make sure you're around.
Don't worry. I won't let anything happen.
I don't want to fall off a horse.
You're a natural.
Yeah, remember, I'm already 65. Okay. Yes, I'm 65. So this has now become your primary house. Why?
Right. So usually when I'm here in the Philippines, yes, I stay with my parents mm-hmm. in the city mm-hmm. and I come here regularly though yeah. to teach mm-hmm. the students and to take care of the horses and to unwind yes. because it's nice, fresh.
How can you not unwind?
Breathe,
this
exactly.
space,
yeah. But now that the pandemic is still going on, yeah. my second home has become my primary home. Yeah. I'm here more often.
Yes.
And also the students come more often as yeah. well. Mm-hmm. And since I'm here in the country yeah. much longer yes. than usual, then it's a great unwinding time for me that
That's
I can stay here.
It's so much fun to see you because every time when you were abroad, I'd see you maybe once every 2 years or you would stop by the office to bring the famous Batangas pandesals. We miss you. So in a way, the pandemic has kept you with us.
Yes, and yeah. I'm really happy to be home yeah. for a longer period yeah. of time. Yeah. The stillness is yeah. good for the mind.
Yes.
And it's a good way to rediscover your roots and yeah, know what's important.
Right?
Exactly. Yeah.
Again, thank you so much for taking me through the whole property. I had so much fun.
Welcome, Tito.
Okay. The pandemic has made us reflect on what's truly important in our lives, and one of them is appreciating our homes. Whatever it may be, transforming our space to welcome changes in the way we live may be challenging, but if planned well and with the right materials, redesigning our home can be a life-changing and fulfilling experience. This is Raul Manzano. Catch the next episode of EIC on the Move and find out where I'm off to next.